It was just a proud moment for me because obviously big supporters, and to have your name in a chant, let's say like that, it's massive, and it's a moment and a reason to be proud.
I think especially for you as well, you've been such a key part of this run to the final. Yeah. I want to talk a little bit in particular about that Arsenal game. It was 0-0 at home, and then we went to the Emirates, and the team were brilliant, but you were sensational that night. Were you conscious that obviously, you know, Mo and Sadio were away? Did you feel like a little bit more pressure on yourself? Not necessarily pressure, but you knew, well, you know, it's on me to get the goals tonight. Do you go in, or do you just sort of play your normal game?
No, just trying to play your normal. I don't overthink. I'm that kind of guy that just be quiet and do your job. And I trust everybody. Even without Sadio and Mo, we are able to win games like we showed. If it's not me, even Ox stepped up in the moments. He scored some important goals for us. So we are a team, and obviously, if they are not there, somebody else will be there, and I truly believe that we have a very good squad to fight for everything like we are doing. But obviously it's always special when you grab a couple of goals. Even in the first game, the send-off was a foul on me. I was expecting us to kind of win it that game, but it didn't really work out, unfortunately. But I was always confident that we could go to Emirates and win, and that's what we did.
Yeah, there was a great away support that night, and the second goal was right in front of them. And it was a funny one, wasn't it? Because you put it in, and the flag goes up, and then there's the big wait. But then the big celebration, and you all kind of decided to run over. It was a nice moment.
Yeah, nice and strange, because I was not really expecting the linesman to give an offside. I was really going for it, for the celebrations. And then when I see, I was, I said it straight away. I'm not offside. And unfortunately for me and for the team, I was not. But it kind of kills the moment a little bit, I would say. You still, after that, obviously you celebrate because the 2-0 almost in the end. But I would say it kills a bit of the joy of the celebration at the moment.
Well, you did your best in the moment to celebrate. It's a big goal. You said before there, you were saying you weren't offside. Do you know as a footballer you're not, or you just sort of tried it on a little bit?
No, to be honest, I told everyone after that, I really thought I was not offside. Yeah. Sometimes you kind of don't know, because it's obviously too quick, everything. But that one, I just felt I was on. And I was.
Yeah, you were right. So fair play. I think that was the night as well where, you know, it was a big away allocation, and you could really hear the fans sort of all night. I wasn't fortunate enough to go. I think my little girl was like 1 week old or something, so I was very much at home. But watch it on the telly, and you could hear the fans, but you could also hear your song booming. And was that the first time that you became sort of aware of it, or was it a couple of times before that where you'd heard your song?
Yeah, I think it was that game. I was not quite sure what they were saying. we had a talk in the physio room after the game, with Chris. He always pays attention. He was, did you hear? And I was, yes, but I'm not sure what they are saying. but yeah, I think that game, it really kicked off, and it was just a proud moment for me, because obviously big supporters, and to have your name in a chant, let's say like that, it's massive, and it's a moment and a reason to be proud of. Yeah,
absolutely. We've got a little video of the concourse that night. I don't know if you've seen this, so we just want to show you a little video of everyone bouncing.
Yeah, I saw.
I'm desperate to join in.
Yeah, it's great.